What's going on, everybody, and welcome to the Full Game Walkthrough Series, episode 83. And today, we start our journey in the beautiful floating islands, legitimately top 5 places in all of the game, in my opinion. Very unique, beautiful. We'll get further into how it's beautiful a little bit later. It's an amazing place. It's kind of a makeshift Triton organic statue that they're praising. So, you know, that's a thing. So we have to talk to Pierce Stanson. Stanson, yes. The floating island as a whole has basically 2 to 3 parts, if you will. The beginning by Pierce. They're trying to cook us up some stew. Hey, Loli! Anyway, the second part. Tiki Village, in a way, and then the crash site. We learn more about the explorers and other things. So let's talk to Pierce and start our adventure.
Hello. How did you get down there without me noticing you? Oh.
We're going to level today, I hope.
Submersible. I had bad news then. It's been a relentless assault since we arrived, and now we're in a bit of a jam.
Literally. Like grape jelly.
Some dastardly saboteurs. Whoa. Untethered our dirigible, the SGS Explorer. We kept our supplies on the dirigible.
That's what that is right there.
Submersible parts to keep them from the water moles, but now the dirigible's gone. Suspecting the worst, we sent a search party after it, but the sea spirits bedeviled us and kept us from searching.
There they are.
If you're willing to help, you're my new best friend. I'm tapped for resources, and I'm so weary. Could you go and roust those blighters?
Well,
don't worry about hurting them. They're just animate seawater. They reform in a jiffy.
They reform in a jiffy. 3K. So let's just defeat these real quick. They're not that bad. And they're ice. So we boost. And we don't have to collect. Which I love. Normally it seems like that's the case around here anyway. 1600 health though, respectfully. Double blade will do it. 35 and a 40. Hopefully all of you are enjoying your day so far. I am really excited to start my day in the floating islands. I legitimately have hype in my veins. You can't really see my veins because that'd be kind of weird. We're like, you know, the inside. But you understand what I'm talking about. One of the best. It's just overall a great experience. Has some trees throughout it. The giant, well, you'll see them eventually. They're like, I can't remember what they're called, but I have them in my red barn farm. You'll be familiar with them. Where the heck is my plus 40 blade? Oh, well, we'll pass one more time. So, maybe you'll be familiar with them because of, they're in my red barn farm. If you watched my gardening series, rest in peace. We're waiting for another update. We're going to pierce him, and then we'll earthquake. A little bit unfortunate that he tower shielded. They have a lot of pips. Maybe it wasn't as easy as I thought, underestimating these guys. Yeah, so whenever, sidetracked, whenever they raise the cap for gardening, I will be doing that. Right now, it's Verdant Gardener, rank 20. So whenever that is changed, I'll be continuing that series. Will this even kill? It has to. If it doesn't kill, I'll be shocked. In all honesty, I will be. I've definitely underestimated these guys. But no biggie. Ice Kraken it is, huh? Better than some bosses in this world. I've been getting pretty lucky, knock on wood. I mean, my crits have been fluent. No joke. Never mind. Not today. It did kill. Perfect. Alright, so one more battle. 2 more sea spirits. I will let you know, the gear that you get here is, it sells roughly for, I want to say, 1 to 3K is max. That's like a, that's really good gear. I like this little water. And we have to collect the supplies, but at least we don't have to defeat anybody. Alrighty. Humongo Frog? I think so. We'll keep that. I was reading the comments. Comment section was lively in the last episode, respectfully, from a lot of reasons. But the comments about the walkthrough, one of them was that I discarded a wand when somebody shielded. And yeah, there's a lot of things I do that are facepalm worthy. So I apologize, but it's the way it goes. 400. Fizzle? Thank you. Alright, double blade. Confirmed. Dead. Unless I fizzle. Praise be to Ivan, I don't. But I've been known to fail. I mean, you know. But there's nothing wrong with failing. Don't see. Oh my gosh, you're my friend, Sea Spirit. Some of the hardest. I wouldn't. For some reason, like, I just always want to call them water elementals. The, presumably, I mean, they're made of water, an element, of course. I mean, unless, you know. Anyway, the hardest ones, like, the most difficult ones are, I want to say, in part two of Chrysalis, I forgot what that's called. And it's terrible for me to forget. It's basically after you get off the Great Bath, and you, it's like the facepalm again. Yeah, it's just, excellent, it is what it is. I can't help it. I'm sorry. I'm having too many brain farts lately.
You know, it occurs to me that if we did something to calm the sea spirits, they'd leave us alone. There's an altar down the way that seems to be devoted to the Storm Lord.
Yes, the altar.
Some sort of patron to the sea spirits. When we arrived on the beach, we saw that the water moles placed pieces of sea foam crystal on the altar. Now the sea foam crystal is gone, and I noticed that the sea spirits leave the water moles well enough alone. Perhaps we should follow suit. Can you go and scavenge up some sea foam crystal from the beach and place it on the Storm Lord altar?
Alrighty, sea foam crystal. Might even have to change realms for this one. A stormy offering. In its own right. I have one of those altars in my villa. It's where I have my... They're cooking the tuna! No! Dory! No! No! These platypus. Platypi? Platypoo? I don't know. One of those is correct, and I'm sure somebody knows the right answer. Alright, seafoam crystal, last piece. Do we have to make a offering? Yeah, use the Stormlord altar. Alright, here we go. Maybe? Oh, the altar, I'm sorry. Not the giant statue. It's in front of me. Alright, altar plus. Back to Pierce. Well, we made our offering. Hopefully it's sufficient, and we don't get banished from the islands. See what Pierce has to say about it.
I hope that did the trick.
I do too. We're about to level, oh my gosh.
It's only part of the problem, I'm afraid. Some wild animals of a type we call Jungle Tooth are raiding our camp. Could you go and see what can be done about those fierce animals? They've two leaders, Wild Crag and Bristleclaw.
Okay.
Defeating those two, oh, two bosses show the here. Rest of the pack that we're not to be trifled with.
All right. 3,963. Well, legitimately, in a few quests, we're going to level. Level 60 hype is real, without a doubt. Oh my, why did I go this way? Most likely gonna happen 2 eps from now, I wanna say. You can never be too sure when you're gonna level anymore. It's always a toss-up. But yes, we're getting further into the jungle. A lot of prelude, I wanna say, environments to Safaria. And there he is. What the heck is in here? Oh yeah, it's beautiful. Look at that. For some reason, I feel like there's even an area in Grizzleheim that was like this, but not as organic. I feel like every world has their own organic area, though. Oh yeah, I forgot to take out prisms. It's my bad. Alright, we'll blade up. These guys won't be that much of a challenge, but they still pose a threat. And it's still in my mind what the heck that place is called in the middle of the ocean between... I want to say it starts with an S. And it's gonna kill me all up. Literally is. It has the four towers. Oh my. Oh well. No need for Talos yet. Hopefully we can find some more blades. Faint even. Then we'll just earthquake. We're sufficient on health. For a while, anyway. Alrighty. No ice. Okay, remove that. Remove that. Keep all this. Spirit blade. Thank you. Pip situation is not the best. This is his main attack, which is like 300. Not bad at all. Oh, another question that people are wondering about. When will I be using Medusa? Well, it depends, because granted, Orthrus does less, but, you know, there's that factor where, you know, removes the shield with the weak hit and then goes mass on the other one. I'll have to see when I use it. I don't really know when the best case scenario is for it, so we'll have to see. Yeah, that's basically all I got. Well, Mythblade again. Plus 40 or Earthquake would be really appreciated. Faint is what we need. I don't even think I have enough feints in. That's my problem. I think we can summon a Talos. I think we need to. Midnight, wake up, possibly, and then we'll heal after Talos if they get more aggressive, because their pips are stacking up. Maybe Talos can hex one of them, that'd be great. Or even stun. Well, see, that's what I'm talking about. And praise be, we found a feint. This is really good. But we do have to be a little bit cautious of what we have in our hand. We don't need another blade, we already have too many of those. We're going to... It's hard to say. I want to use this because if Earthquake pops next, we can use it. And we might even kill, possibly. I know that's pushing it. But it definitely is a possibility. We have more feints than we could ever dream of. I think I'm going to play it safe and heal. Because there... I mean, death at this level doesn't have... Well, this is a bit of a problem. Crit. Thank you for blocking. The minus 25 is a... I'll have to deal with it. For now. At least I healed. Meteor. Talos has 1,000 health though, so he's fine for another 2 rounds, I want to say. I think the best thing he could possibly do after whatever he does and blades himself is stun. Stun is great. But I feel like he's gonna Humunga Frog for some reason. Which is fine, but... Oh no, he's just gonna spam hexes. Alright, ooh, Earthquake, perfect. I don't know why I just removed that plus 25. Alright, well... Pray for a Power Pip next, and then we'll hit. And hopefully find... Pixie, and then we'll be in good hands. Kinda played this battle wrong, but... Make mistakes. But we're still fine. We're still fine. We got it. Really good. And he's Humunga Frogging. He basically, the YOLO goes into effect. 1300 health. Death. pirate most likely going to do 400. The fire only has 3 pips. I don't think he's going to hit. Oh, this is going to do a lot, actually. Like 500, 600 years. No, 500. Praise Midnight. Oh my gosh. She knows her origins. We are in the jungle. She's healing for moons. I mean, this battle actually is now a guaranteed kill because of that one heal. I love it. Weakness, yeah, but this can do a lot. 3k. And he's dead. So now we can just focus on a weak hit. Excuse me. There you go, Talos. No, he's not dead. This isn't gonna do 1500. What am I thinking? For some reason I thought Talos was a player. It happens. Okay. Well, we'll keep that. Remove that. We already have a 35 blade. Don't need that. We have a noob pip. We need to make that go to use. We're gonna faint. Since we don't have a power pip, I think it's best to use this right now. And then I'll shield. Actually turned into more of a struggle than I thought. He's gonna use that feint up. It's fine. I played a few rounds where it went wrong, but we're in good hands. Got Talos by our side. And I rarely use Talos, so. I mean, that's also another thing. Talos is 5 pips, so to regain your pips to hit and do other things, you know, but he does his part, which is all I could ask for. And where the heck is my smaller hits? We're gonna have to use that then. Pass, I guess. We have 2-3 pip. Possibly find a troll. It would be GG if we found a troll, but nope, no troll. Stun. I love it. It's what I want to see. Alright, well, he's dead next. God, Talos is a godsend, though. He definitely takes the cake. Pretty sure you guys remember. Stun immune! Oh yeah, that's right. Never mind. Keep lying to myself. Well, I keep, like, thinking that you can stun, but yeah, I did read that comment where basically all bosses in Celestia. Whoa! Woo heal. What the heck was that? All bosses from now on are stun immune, or the majority of them. Which doesn't go to our favor, but not much you can do with that. Well, finally this cat is dead. He's a wolf. On to the next one. I think about we'll probably get halfway done with floating islands maybe today. Maybe that's a little bit too ambitious though. Some good gear to sell. Wild Crag. Hopefully we can find a Health Wisp. Be really good if we could. To the left. Oh, let's get these Health Wisps. I love it. Good. Awesome. Amazing. Oh, he's over here. Let's get these other ones. Bum, bum, bum. Wild Crag. Yeah, they're all Marley Bone people. I mean, they were an expedition crew, the Spiral Geographic Society. Yep. Ruined village, I feel bad. Well, let's remove these prisms and actually put in things we need. A few more shields. Well, we'll figure out when we get in there, because we're just gonna be cut off anyway. He's Storm. Okay, we need to put in pierces. More pierces than what we have. Well, maybe not that many. So we'll do that, maybe put in, well, no, we don't want that. It's kind of hard to know what to do here. I feel like maybe we can put in all honesty, a few extra enchants. And we should be in good hands. Maybe instead of an Orthrus, we'll put in an extra Humungo. Hopefully we can find our things a little bit quicker this time. Did we just literally... What the heck was that? Is this one of the areas that's, like, glitched? I feel like it is. Oh, well. Alright, we found a plus 40 right away. Stormlord? That's been used before on me. I don't know if I recorded it or not, or maybe it was a mob. I want to say... Yeah, I think I recorded that. It was a boss. Maybe that was in Winter Tusk. Weird. Alright, we don't need these at all. Makes my day when you find the cards you want right on time. Is he literally... Whoa, he just crit on me? Whoa! What the heck? Did we just see that? The heck was that? I'm already down. Midnight! Help! Oh my gosh! I don't know. See, now that scares me because now I feel like I have to buy a crit and a crit block wand. I think at like level. Well, the gear will give me it. Gosh, it's just like a situation that's just kind of scary to be in right now. So he only has 3k health. I have two blades. He's Storm. I think if I faint and then hit next, we kind of have to YOLO it at this point. And I hate to do that, but in all honesty, I think it's the only way. I mean, 800 health, Midnight still hasn't juiced up. She's not really ready for action. I could heal, yes, but I feel like, yeah, we're gonna Earthquake. We have to YOLO it. And if we die, we die. That crit was just insane. Now I probably could have healed. See, that's the thing. If you knew they're gonna pass, and it's whatever. Possible rip plus. Oh my, that was amazing. The YOLO worked. Awesome. Oh, just hit caps lock. It's awkward. We're getting the heck out of here. A little bit closer call than what I expected it to be, but. But yeah, I don't know. Let me know in the comments. So, should I be worried? Should I get more block? Should I get more crit? I don't know. I mean, let's be honest, though. 86 damage is a little bit too excessive, maybe. And maybe I can tone it down a bit. Or maybe I do need to go for damage. I don't know. When we get the Waterworks gear, when we get level 60 hype, we'll make our final decision, I think, then. Right now, we just have to... I mean, I think it's sufficient. I mean, my stats for block... I mean, 50 is, I guess, okay around here. But... I guess we won't know until we know. Logic, 2014.
I wish I could have seen it.
Blue, 2014.
Hopefully, the rest of the Jungle Tooth pack will give us a wide berth now. While you were away, I saw a signal flare from the jungle. That must be from Captain Fogg, who went looking for the Explorer. Captain Fogg went to speak with the Water Moles to see if they had seen the dirigible. Their leader,
Tupatau,
should be happy to help you find the captain.
Oh my gosh. Tupatau the tissue paper. Oh my gosh, I remember this guy. Tupatau the tissue paper. Oh my gosh. I haven't seen this cat for moons. What a treat, though, to meet him today. Oh, for you guys to meet him if you haven't met him yet. He is one of the original tribal members of Celestia. And that was a lag spike. You know, one of the best ways, I think, to maneuver around this area and one of the more unique is we actually go over... Look, I mean, maybe it's just me, all right? But these little creeks and whatnot, I love these, like, little get-em-goods. I love it. I don't know. I just like those little, like, streams. I mean, look at that. Look at this. Look at the view. No way. Tupatau. You can go to the right here. Those blood wings can get a little bit vicious, though. You gotta be careful. best place, one of them, besides the talking waterfall. The heck was that? A raccoon? The Watermole Village. Well, I'll give you a little bit of a tour. He's the chief. Platypus. Sacred fire. Whoa! A little, like, coconut? Pina colada? No. Well, how come I don't get one? Treasure card recipes? I don't remember this guy. Oh, let's get this teleporter. Look at this! How can you not be hyped by, like, this... I'm getting some goosebumps. I don't know why. I need to go talk to Tupa. Sorry. Look at this little grove. Look how close... Oh, my gosh. Okay, you know what? We gotta focus.
Outsider, we have your sky captain.
We leveled, team. Tupa Hike Power. 59.
I am speaker for Water Mole Tribe. I cannot speak to you now. You are a wizard, and I cannot trust your words.
Oh, Tupa.
I had magic stick to protect me from wizard words, but stick was taken by Galwok, big chief of water lurkers. If you bring me back magic stick, I be willing to speak with you, wizard.
Well, Galwok's lair. Let's leave a mark here, because I feel like the teleporter will not be useful. He's down back here, so we'll have to go this way. I think this is the way we have to go. Most likely. So yeah, one of the more beautiful places, I think. I mean, the entire area just screams amazingness. Amaze, really. We have to go back over in here. I feel like he's going to be Storm. If he's Myth, that won't be good at all. Just cause more problems. But it's nothing we can't handle. Like always, you know, the Myth people just pose a little bit more of a struggle, but... But being a... They call it the Water Lurkers. Alright. Oh, he's Fire! Oh, and... Well, he's called a Water... Shaking my head, Tau. Remove these. Where the prism's at. Put two of those in. Remove these. We don't need as many as those. And I think we're good. He's fire, so...
You will not take magic stick from me! Galwok using it to break open shells!
Guess he likes crab. Love how we're just getting a stick. Like, the logic of this area. I love it. Don't need that. Don't need that. Well, No, we don't. We just need one prism. And I'm happy we went first. This is... Going first in prisming, like I said previously, is one of the best things in the world. The heck was that? A barrel roll? This hand is interesting. Alright, we don't need Seder. Oh, whoa. That would... Well, actually, no. We don't want to do that. Anyway, don't need that early on. It's really good. Kind of a clutter right there. Remove that. We can time a legend. Plus 35 is really good, though. Helps out a lot, actually. Just getting a stick. Dubitayu is a bit crazy, though. But you have to be. You know what I mean? You definitely have to be. Don't need that. Well, remove that. I'm not going to keep that, even though it's probably the wisest thing to do. Well, not really the wisest thing. We can't have any clutter. Blading him up. It's really good that he wasted that, even though he's never going to use a fire blade, so that's awesome. We already have that. We don't need Talos. Not this late, I feel like. And plus, he only has 4k health. We're not going to need him. We're going to keep blading up and try and go for that one shot, one kill. I think it's going to work best for... Now, he's fire. We don't boost on fire, but, you know. If I find a troll in hand, I'll be a little bit more aggressive. I might even just hit. And I didn't find it, so we'll keep that. Spirit Blade. It's gonna do mass. I think right now with the three blades, it'll do about three. Well, since the plus 35's up as well, the bubble. 3k, I wanna say. But I could be wrong. Somewhere in there, ish. I guess. Why not? We'll faint, and then we'll hit. And then he should be dead. These draws are perfect. They really are. He does like to use this spell, though. And he does have a blade and a trap on me, so it's gonna do about 800, 700. It's gonna do a fair amount, but he's dead anyway. We will fight a lot more of these people later on in Celestia. I'm trying to recall what's after the floating island, and maybe that's... I think it's Stormriven, I want to say. I know it's not the Science Center. I know that for a fact. It's not the Science Center. It's either Stormriven. Crustacean Empire is moons away. Well, yeah, moons. Yeah, I think it's Stormriven. I think in Stormriven we get the second piece of the Astrolab that we need. Excuse me. Faint, triple blade. We should be good. And if not, we'll heal next with Seder, with the life mastery that we have, which is really awesome. Smoothest boss run we've had. We've had out of all of them today, which is really good. They're all dead. Rest in pepperonis. Okay. Back to Tupa Taui the toilet paper. The heck is that? Accurate. See, they're just giving me these TCs to remind me how I failed with buying keen eyes. They're trolling me. Tupa!
Now have magic stick. We safe to talk.
If you want to. Boy, is that literally back, the. You must is that seriously the molds. Stick? That's hilarious.
Jungle Tooth stole our sacred idols, took them into the jungle. Water moles afraid to go look for them. You not afraid. We watch you fight Jungle Tooth before. Now you go find water mole idols and bring back.
I mean, he's a legendary guy, but he's so cheap with his XP. Like, he's given 2k to go collect 6. Like, I'm shaking my head. Where the heck are these idols? I think they're by the waterfall. Or maybe they're up here by the... What do you call these people? Jungle Tooth people. Oh, yeah, they're by the... He just said Jungle Tooth. What am I doing? It happens. Confused sometimes. Oh, there's a second one. Look at these little crevices. Where's this lead? Oh, it leads back here. Well, that's no fun. You don't want to go underneath. You gotta go above, over the bridge. That's the fun part. But maybe that's just me. Alright, two water idols. Whoa! Well, that was a lag spike. Nothing I can do. Let me just kill these people real quick, then. And we went first. 2k? I've had a few lag spikes out today, but... I don't know. Maybe it's because I have certain programs open. Well... We don't need these things at all. It's just double blade. Well, actually, might even have to triple blade since they're life. But since they're life, they don't pose that much of a threat. We should be fine. This is just my bad. But mistakes like this happen. You gotta find Earthquake is what we have to do. Spirit Blade, plus. We still have our boss deck on, too, which might take a little while to find what we need, but pretty lucky so far. The heck is this? Talk about voodoo. A life banshee? I think the last time we saw that was back in Wizard City. Or maybe even Croc. I don't know. One of those two. Maybe even Marleybone. I know we haven't seen it for many, many worlds. I'm talking about like two or three. Maybe even four. Ooh. Okay, we'll draw that. Maybe. Thank you. And we are going to Spirit Blade to make sure we kill with one hit. Not waste our pips, even though our pips are prime right now. I guess it didn't turn out to be that big of an issue. Again with the life banshee. Gives that plus 25 trap. I guess if they would spam it constantly, that'd actually be really good. But they're dead. So no chance to spam today. Bum bum bum. That would have been hilarious if I would have created, we did like 6k or so, or 5k. Oh, 6k, 5k. One of those k's. Alright, well, let's get the heck out of here. Oh, and one of by the time we defeated it, one of them respawned. Okay. He's gotta be, we gotta be a little bit more careful around here. Oh, two more. Are they down here? Whoa, it's this little bridge. Oh yeah, they are over here. Okay, let's just go get it. The heck is back here? Like, why are there just like two rocks? Well, let's just change realms real quick. I'm just bathing in the sun. I guess I'll just go to random one. Doesn't really matter. Water mole. There we are. Alright, back to Tupa. We're gonna take this little bridge. Gosh, it just gets me every time. Keep the mark over here for future.
You bring them.
Yes, I did bring them all back, my brother.
I almost,
you're cheap with your XP is what you are.
With Water Mole Tribe, but you're not there yet. Jungle Tooth,
defeat five
village. If you go and fight them, they think you one of us and leave us alone.
Well, defeat five. Okay. Well, anyway, leave a like if you've enjoyed today. I want to say we're about almost halfway done with the floating island. I know it takes a little bit while over here by the crash site after we get done a little bit more familiar with Tupa Tuai, the tissue paper. We will further our way, talk to the cascading waterfall, literally talks to us. He's like, with the roots of the water. So yeah, leave a like if you've enjoyed. Enjoy the rest of your day. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Most likely finish up Floating Island. Yeah. So anyway, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Enjoy the rest of your day.